Welcome students to Navin sir physics classes. So in last lectures we discussed about some special cases based on parallelogram law of vectors and triangle law of vectors. So in this lecture we are going to see how to resolve a vector in 2D and 3D. Let us begin the session. So with resolution of a vector in two dimension, this concept we can also rectangular component of rectangular components of vector in 2D. So 2D means it is a plane. It may be xy plane, yz plane or zx plane. Okay, so I am taking a vector a bar in the plane. So generally we know that in 2D we can represent a vector as axi plus ayj. So the angle made by the vector is theta. I am resolving this, I am dividing or I am splitting this vector into two components. One is along x axis and another one is along y axis. Along x axis is horizontal component and along y axis is vertical component ay. So I am closing this and this also I am going to get ay. Right, o p q. So in this OQ we can write cos theta. So cos theta is equal to OQ by OP. So OQ is AX and OP. Sir, what is OP? OP is the magnitude of the vector. So we can write under root of AX square plus ay square. So OP magnitude is ax and a bar is we can write as a, therefore cos theta ax equals to a cos theta. This is horizontal component. And then next sin theta from the same figure. Sin theta is equal to ay by a, we can write ay is equal to a sin theta. So this is what vertical component of a vector. So this rectangular components gives the information about the angle made by the vector with the axis. With respect to x axis, the angle made by the vector is cos theta equals to ax by a. With respect to y axis, angle made by the vector is ay by a. Okay, right. Here, if you add this square and adding these two, suppose this is equation number 1, equation number 2, let us do 1 square plus 2 square. So, ax square plus ay square, a square cos square theta plus a square sin square theta. So, after getting common a square, we can write cos square theta plus sin square theta. Right. So ax square plus ay square. Therefore, a is equal to under root of ax square plus ay square. So this is a way of finding or getting the magnitude of the vector. So sometime based on this concept, the question will be framed like this. A vector a bar is given by 2i plus 2j. They're asking find angle made by vector with x-axis. So angle made by the vector with x-axis, first we should know what is the magnitude of this. Magnitude of this vector we can write, we should compare this as axi plus ayj. So in this, 2 square plus 2 square root 8. So this we can write 2 root 2 also. Next, they are asking angle made with x-axis. So I am taking cos theta. Cos theta is equal to ax by a. What is ax? 2. And what is a? 2 root 2. So after cancelling this, we are going to get cos theta as 1 by root 2. So for which value of theta? Cos becomes 1 by root 2 for theta 45. So this question we can also do another model. Another way also we can do the same question. Let us see that also. The same question they given. A bar is equal to 2i plus 2j. So we should compare this vector with axi plus ayj. So we got already a as 2 root 2. First we should find its magnitude. Then in last we discussed cos theta as ax by ay. I am going to write ay by ax because ax is equal to a cos theta and ay equals to a sin theta. If I am doing this 2 by 1, what I am going to get? Ay by ax is equal to sin by cos, that gives tan theta. So we can also find tan theta. Let us check whether we are getting the same answer or different answer. Tan theta is equal to ax, 2 by 2. So theta, tan theta equals to 1. Therefore theta value equals to 45 degree. And if they asked angle made by the vector with respect to y-axis. If they are asking angle made by the vector with respect to y-axis. So we can approach with the sin theta. Sin theta is equal to ay by a. So ay equals to what? 2. And a 2 root 2. We are going to get 1 by root 2. So theta is equals to 45. So in all the cases we are going to calculate whatever the angle made by the given vector with respect to x-axis in the same way with respect to y-axis. Now let us discuss about the resolution of a vector in 3D. So how can we resolve a vector in 3 dimension? Let us discuss that. So rectangular components of a vector in 3D. So in 3D we know that already how to represent a vector in 3 dimension. We can represent a vector as a bar is equal to axi plus AYJ plus AZK. So AX is X component, AY is Y component, AZ is Z component. In the same way, I, J and K are what? Are the unit vectors, along X, Y and Z axis. Let us take this vector A bar. Okay, what is the magnitude of this vector? Mod A bar is nothing but its magnitude. Simply we can represent A. We are going to get under root of AX square plus AY square plus AZ square. This is the magnitude. Okay, right. Sir, what about angles? How to find out the angle? So to find the angle made by the vector with respect to Y, X and Z, I am going to introduce a concept of direction cosine. So angle made by the vector with respect to X axis alpha, with respect to Y axis beta and with respect to Z axis gamma. Okay, we are going to get direction cosines. The direction cosines gives about the information. Cosines gives the information about angle made by the vector with X, Y and Z axis. So with respect to X axis, cos alpha is equals to AX by A. With respect to Y axis, cos beta is equals to AY by A. And with respect to Z axis, cos gamma equals to AZ by A. So these are the direction cosines. So which helps in finding the angle made by the vector with respect to X, Y and Z axis. So here we have a relation between these quantities. Let us see the relation between that quantities. So we know that cos alpha AX by A, cos beta AY by A and cos gamma is AZ by A. So the magnitudes cos square alpha plus cos square beta plus cos square gamma equals to 1. This, if you want to express in terms of sine also, we can write. So 1 minus sine square alpha plus 1 minus sine square beta plus 1 minus sine square gamma equals to 1. So sine value shifting that side, sine square alpha plus sine square beta plus sine square gamma equals to 3 minus 1 we are going to get to. So this is the relation between direction cosines and as well as the sine angles. So based on this, in what way the question can be framed? Let us take one example. A vector is given to you A bar as 2i minus 3j plus 4k. They are going to ask, find the direction cosines of vector. So direction cosines, we should find cos alpha, cos beta and cos gamma. So before going to find out this cos alpha, We know the formula ax by a, ay by a, and az by a. A nothing but what here? A is the magnitude of vector. Magnitude of vector. So how to find its magnitude? We know the formula under root of ax square. So 2 square plus of minus 3 square plus 4 square. So what we are going to get? 4 plus 9 plus 16. That is 25, 29. Root 29 we are going to get. Now let us substitute here in cos alpha. So cos alpha ax is value 2. So 2 by root 29. And ay, if it is negative, we can write with negative sign only. Minus 3 by under root of 29. And the same way cos gamma. So cos gamma value az, 4 by root 29. So in this way we can find direction cosines for a given vector. Okay, nah? So this rectangular components of vectors is very very important in dealing with the forces, in dealing the forces and in dealing the velocities. Okay, where the resolution is required. If the vectors are moving in a x-axis or y-axis or z-axis, no issues. But suppose if they are not moving, if the forces or velocities or any vector is not acting in along x and y, if they're acting along, suppose xy plane by making some angle theta. So they are going to ask, if force is equal to 2 Newton, if theta is 30 degree, they are going to ask what is the x component of the force and what is y component of the force. This is also, you can take it as example, you can write in the notes. So vector is represented in xy plane. So magnitude of the vector is given as 2 Newton and angle made by this force vector is 30 degree. They are asking what is the force acting along x-axis and y-axis. So how to do this? Fx, we know that f cos theta, because horizontal component. Fy, we know that f sin theta. So substitute the values in this. So fx we are going to get as 2 into cos 30. So cos 30 value root 3 by 2, that is root 3. Root 3 Newton is the force which is acting along x-axis. Next, force acting along y-axis. So force acting along y-axis, that is f sin theta. F value is given, sin theta is, sin 30 is 1 by 2, we are going to get 1. Let us check it whether we are getting the same value or not. So f nothing but what? Root of ax square plus ay square. So root 3 square is 3 plus 1. So root 4 is 2. So this is the way of checking whether we are getting the proper answer or wrong answer. Okay, in next lecture we are going to see the numericals. So take care, stay safe.